to come up and hug me, so don't be surprised. After 12 years, this is just, and she said bittersweet. It's worse than bittersweet. I can't get it over to somebody in that place. Did you hear what the word that I can't even spell that Irish used? It really describes, I would put that in my literature, the marketing Hayes Cooper. She described it as a sanctuary. I couldn't have thought of a better word. Where's ours? Well, ours, I've been coming, trying to come up all day with a word to describe our feelings about Hayes Cooper. People, everybody in the back, can you hear me? Sounds okay? I've been trying to come up with a word all day. Sanctuary. I mean, how blessed are we as parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, guardians to have had Hayes Cooper in our lives? Who does not feel blessed by that? Stand up! Just kidding. You know, you see the opposite. Who was Hayes Cooper? I asked my son on the way up here, who went to school here. John, who was Hayes Cooper? I said, there's a plaque to him and a photo in the office. I said, well, who was he? Who was he? I'm not putting you on the spot. Who was he? You don't know Mariana Fulcher? Who was Hayes Cooper? Who knows that it's not an employee of the school? Who knows? Anybody know? Come on, I got $5 for somebody who knows. Come on. Who knows who Hayes Cooper was? Self-fulfilling prophecy. Is it because of this spark? So y'all are two sixth grade teachers? Let's stay, stand up. Yeah, come on, let's get up. Could be wrong, but what I think is that their self-fulfilling prophecy is what they think and what they're putting in your mind, they're making come true. Now, you could be unfortunate. You could really be unfortunate and have two teachers plus multiple more out there over the years, Beverly Hardy and all the rest, who were telling you that you can't do things, that this is not a safe sanctuary for you, that this is not a good learning environment, that you're never going to make it. But look at your teachers. You will owe them for the rest of your life. Anybody know more? Thank you. If I tell you, just sit and stay up right away. Stand back up. All right, somebody cut me off now, because I do this. Cut me off. Hey, I was having lunch with Morgan Freeman in 1999. Why are you laughing? In 1999, I was having lunch with Morgan Freeman at the rest haven. Rest haven, Mr. Foster, in Clarksdale. And I said, Mr. Freeman, I said, aren't you so interested in education and the giving back to the schools and taking care of children? He told me his third grade teacher, Leola Williams, he said she pulled four of them out of class in Greenwood, and said, Freeman, you can be somebody. Don't sell yourself short. He said that one sentence from his teacher, you know Morgan Freeman, right? That one sentence from his teacher changed his life. He said whenever he got down, he thought about that. So what if your parents and grandparents and Hayes Cooper, I told y'all today. I'm saying think about the power of your what goes into your mind. Don't let anybody tell you anything negative that you can't do. Do you know what happens when you get to be a senior in high school? By the time they say you get to be a senior in high school, you learn your limitations. Because school teaches you limitations. Some schools do, not Hayes Cooper. So I'm only here today to congratulate the teachers and to publicly thank Hayes Cooper for doing everything. I'm going to cry now. Everything you've done for my family. And I want everybody in this whole building stand up and hoop it up for the faculty and staff of Hayes Cooper. Stand up and let's give it up for Hayes signature. I'm on the top. Thank you.